In this case, we're calculating chemical equilibrium, where we have a liquid, calcium, and a crystal, solid, reacting to form two other crystals, two other solids, and we're given delta G standard state conditions at 1,000 degrees and 1,200 degrees centigrade. We want to know what's the maximum temperature where the calcium will actually reduce the thorium oxide to thorium metal. And a critical aspect is we're assuming all these phases are pure. In other words, the thorium solid does not mix with the calcium oxide solid. They're in separate phases. And this dramatically affects the equilibrium. So we're going to apply chemical equilibrium, where equilibrium constant is ratio of activities. So calcium oxide squared, activity of thorium solid, activity of calcium squared, and then the activity of thorium oxide. Because the activity is a ratio of fugacities, and if standard conditions is one bar, since they're pure components, pressure doesn't affect the activities very much for solids or liquids. Each of the activities is equal to one, therefore the equilibrium constant is one, and of course this is dimensionless. So the equilibrium constant is related to the change in the Gibbs free energy at a given temperature, which means one is equal to, and so this means it happens that delta G is zero at the conditions where we satisfy equilibrium. So what we're going to do, delta G, from its definition, is delta H minus T delta S. And we're going to assume we can write this equation at the two temperatures where we know values for delta G, and assume they have the same delta H. Namely, delta H doesn't change much with temperature. That's usually a pretty good assumption that over a smaller temperature range, heat reaction doesn't change very much. We're also assuming here that delta S is not changing very much since we're dealing with solids. So the delta S for the reaction, we'll assume, is not changing very much. If we make those assumptions, then we can essentially write down two equations from our data here. We can write down at 1,000 degrees C, and I'll write this now in calories, is delta H, so this equal sign, minus temperature, and absolute temperature, and delta S, and then at 1200 degrees C, 2000 is the value we're given, same delta H, absolute temperature, the same delta S, and we basically then can just solve these simultaneously, and we can calculate delta H as minus 12,320 calories per mole, and delta S as minus 7 calories per mole Kelvin. So we're looking for the temperature where delta G is zero. So zero is equal to delta H minus T delta S, and so therefore we substitute in, temperature is 1760 Kelvin. So what this means is that at temperatures below this, the reaction will be in forward direction and will reduce. So for T less than 1760 Kelvin, we reduce the thorium oxide. At higher temperatures, the equilibrium constant decreases, the reaction will go to the left. Because the activities are one for the pure components, reaction will proceed to the left until there's no thorium left. So to get reduction, we have to be below 1760 Kelvin.